Greetings of the day, students. I, Asmita Patil, welcome you all to Chapter 5, Revenue Management. In this particular chapter, we are going to learn about concept, definition, and importance of revenue management, elements of revenue management, benefits of revenue management, using revenue management. Let's see the definition of revenue management. Revenue management refers to the strategic distribution and pricing tactics you use to sell your property's perishable inventory to the right guests at the right time to boost revenue growth. Hotel products and services are perishable. That means they cannot be stored for a future sale. The room not sold on a particular day is a loss of revenue. Concept of revenue management. The concept of revenue management originated in the airline industry. Most travelers know that passengers on the same flight often pay different fares. Super saver discounts, 14-day advance purchase plans, non-refundable fares, and so forth have become the norm for airline pricing. What is not as widely known is the potential application of revenue management to other service industries like hotels. In case of hotels, the reservations are taken for a perishable commodity. The key to successful implementation appears to be an ability to monitor demand and to develop reliable forecasts. When hotels first started using revenue management, they focused strictly on guest room rates and the basic economic principles of supply and demand. If demand for room nights was projected to be low, that is, if the forecast was for low occupancy, the revenue management strategy would dictate keeping room rates low in an attempt to attract as much business as possible. The idea was to convert every room availability inquiry into a reservation even at a low rate. As demand increased for the targeted time frame, the hotel would increase its room rates. Hotels tended to align rate strategies with market segmentations by offering select discounts to featured groups such as American Automobile Association members and AARP members. In addition, hotel did some specialized forecasting. For example, the number of current reservations for a future date may be low, but if a citywide convention was coming to town at that time, a hotel manager might believe the hotel would actually have higher occupancy and would fine-tune room rates and projected occupancy accordingly. As hotel managers became more comfortable with the concept and application of revenue management strategies, they realized there were more effective ways to adjust rates while maximizing occupancy. Hotel companies conducted extensive analysis of guests who stayed at their hotel as well as those who preferred to stay elsewhere. Managers realized that room rates could accurately be adjusted based upon the demand of a specific market segment. Let us understand the importance of revenue management. The managers focused on making the best of each selling opportunity. Key to successful revenue management is to sell the right product to the right customer. Evaluate the total revenue potential of a guest. Revenue management is about making predictions about business coming from the future. You have to attract the ideal guest to your hotel. Revenue management improves the brand image of the hotel. It focuses on each group or department within a hotel on the actions to be taken to increase profitability. It makes overall company more efficient by driving down the cost. It leads to innovation in both the creation of new products and services and their pricing. It helps in improving demand forecasting. It helps to maintain a right balance between general managers, revenue managers, and hospitality managers. It gives the hospitality personnel an idea of how to manage revenue growth. It helps in gaining competitive intelligence and market awareness. It helps a person to critically consider a condition and also provide the best techniques towards a possible hotel management system. It reduces the time and cost associated with traditional pricing tactics. Elements of revenue management. The fact that flexible room rates affect the number of guests and associated revenue transactions help demonstrate the potential complexity of revenue management. Focusing attention only on room revenue potential may not present management with a comprehensive view. Revenue management becomes even more complex when room rate discounting is granted on a selective rather than general basis, and when it involves selling rooms for which there may be competing buyers. Hotels frequently offer discounts to certain categories of guests, for example, senior citizens, government officials. Hotels must also decide whether to accept or refuse group business at a discounted rate. The following elements must be included in the development of successful revenue management strategy: group room sales, transit room sales, other revenue opportunities, local and area-wide activities, special events. One of the most important issues to understand about revenue management is that the practice changes from property to property. It may also change from season to season within a property due to sources of business, competition, and other issues. However, there are certain elements important to developing a basic revenue management skills. So let us see group room plans. In many hotels, groups form the nucleus of room revenue. It is common for hotel to receive reservations for group sales from 3 months to 2 years in advance. You have to see that does the group request fit into the hotel's strategy for the period? Are they using the meeting spaces in the hotel? The meal requirement of the group, is it going to give us the business? And what revenue can the hotel plan to earn from rooms, F&B and other sources in case of group business? Now let us understand that what are these transit room plans. Transit room plans includes rooms are sold to non-group travelers. Business is booked closer to the date of arrival. In case of group, it is booked from 3 months to 2 years in advance before the arrival. Classify rooms by location, size, and premium. Offer deluxe rooms at a standard rate to attract business. You have to also see what your competitor is doing. And discounts to be offered to corporate and government traveler, travel agents, airline, etc. contribute to the overall GPA of the community. In case of bookings, rooms and banquets can give more profit to the hotel. Food and beverage sales contribute to the overall profitability of the hotel. Many hotels will not accept banquet-only business during a projected high demand period. Now let us understand how the special events contribute to the overall revenue. Quite often, special events such as holiday celebrations, concerts, festivals, and sporting events are held in or near a hotel. The hotel may be able to take advantage of such demand-enhancing activities by restricting room rate discounts or requiring a minimum length of stay. These are nothing but the revenue management tactics, and if they are planned carefully, the hotel will earn good revenue. Let's see the benefits of revenue management. All hotel companies have a common problem. They have a fixed inventory of perishable products that cannot be stored if unsold by a specific time. The real commodity that hotels sell is time in a given space. If a room goes unsold on a given night, there is no way to recover the time lost and therefore the revenue lost. Thus, these products are typically sold for varying prices that depend on the timing of the transaction and the proposed date of delivery. To make predictions called forecasts, managers need information. They have to understand the property and the competitive market in which the property operates. They also need to consider future events or variables that might affect business. Forecasts help determine whether room rates should be raised or lowered and whether a reservation request should be accepted or rejected to maximize revenue. Front office managers have successfully applied such demand forecasting strategies to room reservation systems, management information systems, room and package pricing, rooms and revenue management, seasonal rate determination, pre-theater dinner special and special rate room operator and travel agent rates. The front office managers have identified several benefits of revenue management. Let's see, improved forecasting, improved seasonal pricing, inventory decisions, identification of new market segments, identification of market segment demands, enhanced coordination between front office and sales division, determination of discounting activity, value-based rate structure. This is the chart of how to use the revenue management. Hotel needs to determine revenue management strategies for both high and low demand periods. During times of high demand, the normal technique is to increase a room revenue by maximizing average room rate. Transient and group business market segments may each require a unique and specific strategy. In case of an high demand tactics, close or restrict discounts. Analyze discounts and restrict them as necessary to maximize the average rate. You may offer discounts for those who book longer stays or restrict bookings to shorter stays. Minimum length stay. A minimum length of stay restriction can help a property increase room nights. For groups, study the group's patterns and decide how many days they are likely to add to their stay. Reduce group room allocations. Communicate with group leaders on a regular basis. Make sure the group actually needs the number of rooms identified in its contract. If not, make adjustments. You have to tighten the reservation policies. This is very, very important aspect. Next point, rates to be raised at par with the competitors. Charge rates consistent with the competition, but limit rate increase to those rates published in the central reservation system and listed in brochures for the people. Select close to arrival dates. By allowing reservations to be taken for a certain date as long as the guest arrives before that date, a property is able to control the volume of check-ins. It is important to track and monitor denials that occur due to this restriction. Raise rates for packages. If you are already offering a package discount, considering raising the rate for that package. Next point, minimize early departures so that you do not lose on the revenue. Now, in case of a potential low demand tactics, sell value and benefits. Rather than just quoting rates, make sure guests know how to have the right product for them and the best value. Sell the various values and benefits of staying at the property versus others that guests may be considering. Offer packages. To increase room nights, one tactic is to combine accommodations with a number of desirable products and services into single packages with one price. Mention any additions, renovations, or new amenities. Non-room revenue can be included, for example, free movies, discounted attraction tickets, and shopping coupons. Next point, keep discount categories open. Discounts are typically directed towards particular markets or are instituted during a particular time or season. During low demand time, it is important to accept discount to encourage room night. Next point, offer stay-sensitive price incentives. A stay-sensitive price incentive provides a discount for guests who stay longer. Next point, remove stay restrictions. Remove any stay restrictions so guests are not limited as to when they can arrive to park. Guests who can only stay one night will be encouraged to stay as well as the guests who stay for a day. This will help to maximize occupancy. It is extremely important to communicate this to staff as well as to the central reservation system staff. Involve your staff. Create an incentive contest to increase occupancy and make sure to involve all members of your staff as well as central reservations. Relationship with competitors. Having a cordial relationship with competitors can help with referrals and can help to carry out cross-marketing. There are three types of demand tactics that is used for demand management: potential high demand tactics, low demand tactics, non-financial. Now, by implementing the revenue strategies, you have to offer minimum length of stay, close to arrival, hurdle rate, and sell-through. Now, what is hurdle rate? Rack rates are always left open, whether demand is high or low. Then, the front office manager must set the lowest rate for a given date based upon anticipated demand. Rates that fall below this minimum will not be offered. This is sometimes called the hurdle rate.